as we speak, and I want to join Governor Simba Arati, a forthright, straightforward governor afraid of nobody except God. People of Kisii, tuliongea nanyi wakati ule mwingine. Tukasema wakijaribu kumuumiza Governor Simba Arati, wajue sio watu wa Kisii peke yao, Kenya nzima. Kwanza huyu ni deputy naibu, is actually one of the deputy chair of ODM. Wajigamba sana watu wa ODM, wasema ODM. I think tutaanza ndugu Arati na sisi tuanze kusema WDM. But he is a leader. He's in the coalition of Azimio coalition. We are very proud of you. Fearless leader. Fearless Kenyan leader. Na wasihi watu wa Bagusi, muangalie vile mambo yalivyo, simameni kwa ukweli. I'm not here to defend him. I'm here actually to say kwaheri to my brother Charles Birundo. But as we do so, we have to speak some of these truths. We spoke that time. Strictly, in accordance with our constitution, no Kenyan should live under fear. It is the responsibility of any government to make sure that Kenyans are safe, of course the Kenyan government anywhere in the world, and that their properties are also safeguarded. Kwa hivyo maisha wananchi ni kitu ya maana. Mwananchi akiwa kiongozi ama akiwa mwananchi wa kawaida, hata kama ni wale, you know, when our Lord and Savior was telling the prostitute, go and sin no more. Watu wa kawaida pia walikuwa wametoroka. They are under protection under our constitution, which recognizes the supremacy of God. So I just want to remind those who are threatening Governor Simba Arati, don't think we are forgotten. Tunawasubiri mjaribu, lakini msijaribu. We are praying after today, as we say kwaheri to Birundo. We don't want to hear of any political assassinations in this country anymore. Naomba tu nikomeshe kufika hapo. Advice. Advice as somebody with a bit of knowledge on these things, and one who loves their country. We cannot celebrate 61 years of it internal self-rule when we are subject to other nations, or when we get aligned the wrong way. And I think the church also pray for this. I reminded Kenyans that in 1998, tulipigwa bomu Nairobi na Dar es Salaam. We were not non-aligned members of NATO. Now we are getting aligned. Tutapigwa kivipi? We were 200 Kenyans, still some of them blind, never been compensated. The 22 Americans who lost their lives were looked after. I was Minister for Education when it happened. Very painful. That is why Kenya took the principled position of positive non-alignment, maintaining our friendship with the United States of America, with everybody. Kibaki was accused of looking east. William was asked on CNN, are you looking west? Akasema, no, 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 we are not looking east, or we are looking forward. Well, this is the truth about where we are as a nation today. So let's pray for, I'll pray for William Ruto, so he doesn't take us to the ditch. If we are hit by a terrorist bomb because we are seen to be a pawn of one major state or a major world power, we'll hold it, we'll hold Kenya Kwanza to account. Because lazima tukiwa hai, before we separate from these bodies like our brother has done, we have things to do. And we must do them well. This is a democratic nation. And it will remain as such. And nobody, by the way, is above the law. Donald Trump, so many years after being president one term, the law of America has caught up with him. And he's actually, by the way, a presidential candidate in November. Yesterday, 12 juries found him guilty of manipulating business records. Imagine, kama ungekuja kwa Kenya leo, uchaji watu manipulation business records. Eh. So nobody is above the Kenya Constitution. And everybody then is accountable, even those who are looking for leadership positions. So, we will demand accountability on this gift from the United Emirates, Arab Emirates. We want accountability. And I started the National Prayer Breakfast, where William was speaking from yesterday. I was happy to have been the very first chair when we invited the former president of Nigeria, General Yakub Gowon, was the first speaker. These are important spiritual matters. Let us not use occasions like those to also do incredible other things. Kwa hivyo mimi sitaki niongeze hayo. Accountability. Governance, Archbishop Marita, governance, even in church. Even in church, governance. Yeah, Kenya Church took a position. We all know it. Please let us pray for each other. And I want to ask church, I once said, at the inauguration of Bishop Ogide of Sitam, when I was vice president, I said, church, speak. Ah, I earned myself a title of a watermelon. All right? But I say, please, do not allow any more shakaholas here. Tafadhalini. Let us all live and be able to be accountable before God Almighty. Kwa hivyo, mimi na watakieni, familia, kila laheri, we will be with you. By the way, Governor Simba, that young man, Nixon, when